For over 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun.
Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win.
The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And thank you very much. Hi again, everybody. We welcome you to another brand new game of Granite State Challenge. We are really right in the middle of our first round of competition. We have 16 opening round games between 32 of New Hampshire's high schools. We've had 5 winners so far, 2 new schools to play against each other tonight, the winner also to advance into our second round of play. So let's introduce you to the players and the schools participating tonight. First of all, we have the team from Colebrook Academy, enrolling about 145 students, located in New Hampshire's Coos County.
Hi, I'm Teresa Andalina, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Dean Woodard-Neri, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Natalie Dosty, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Mark Frizzell, and I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Robert Unangst, and his alternate tonight is Kelby Byron, and they are the Mohawks of Colebrook Academy. So there's the team from Colebrook. Let's introduce you to their opponents for tonight's game. This is the team from the Derryfield School, enrolling about 260 students and located in New Hampshire's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Brandon Wilson, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Fink, and I'm a junior.
I'm Kate Jorgensen, and I'm a junior.
I'm Tucker Napoli, and I'm a senior.
Joining us as well is the coach for the team, Dennis Holland, and his alternates, Kim Selwyn and Kelly McDonald, the Cougars of the Derryfield School. Those are the two teams participating tonight. One last introduction to let you know who our judges are. And tonight we say hello to Ann Belanger and Mary Riley Potter. Thank them again. All right, we are ready to play. We play in 4 rounds. This opening round will be a 10-point toss-up round. We'll tell you about our bonus in 62nd round down the road. Colebrook Academy, Derryfield School. Good luck. Here we go for 10 points. In Germany, what decoration is the center of all Christmas celebrations? Dean of Colebrook Academy?
Christmas tree.
That is correct. The Christmas tree is it. Identify the surname of Sherlock Holmes' assistant, Dr. John H. Dean of Colebrook.
Watson.
John H. Watson is right. Now for 10 points. Name the type of rock formed from the 2 other major kinds of rock by extreme heat. Caitlin of Derryfield School.
Metamorphic
rock is correct. All right, there is paper and pencil found in front of you. You might want to use it for this math question. Simple enough, we want you to solve the equation 3x plus 7 equals 13. Natalie of Colebrook.
2
is right for the 10 points. Now for 10 points, name the South Carolina capital which surrendered to Caitlin of Derryfield School.
Charleston.
I can repeat it for Colebrook Academy. Name the South Carolina capital, Natalie.
Columbia
surrendered to Sherman in February 1865. Well done. Name the musical instrument, a large 4-stringed piece shaped like a violin, Tucker of Derryfield.
The bass.
Judges, no, that is not correct. Let's go over to Colebrook. Name the musical instrument, a large 4-stringed piece shaped like a violin but held between the knees in an upright position. Teresa.
Cello.
A cello is correct for your team's 10 points. Here's your next 10-pointer. Which author, who died in 1991, made green eggs and ham palatable to many readers, Tucker of Derryfield?
Dr. Seuss.
Dr. Seuss is right. How many months are there in 3 3/4 years? Brandon of Derryfield?
30.
Colebrook Academy? Cormac?
39.
It is 45. For 10 points, teams, tell me quickly, which 2 planets are the closest to the Earth? Tucker of Derryfield.
Mars and Venus.
You got them both for your 10 points. How many heads does Cerberus, the dog who guarded the gate of Tucker?
3.
Say again.
3.
He does have 3 heads. Good anticipation. Well done. In which state is Washington Irving's short story entitled Rip Van Winkle set? Cormac of Colebrook Academy.
New York.
New York State is right. Paper and pencil once again. A military exercise began at 2200 hours on June 4th and ended at 0300 hours on June 6th. How many hours elapsed? Tucker of Derryfield.
31.
Colebrook. Natalie.
29.
Is correct. 29 is right. We use simple machines every day. What sort of simple machine is a claw hammer? Brandon of Derryfield.
A wedge.
Colebrook. Dean.
Leverage.
A lever. Leverage is correct. It is a lever. Very quickly now for 10 points. Along which river is the Aswan Dam? Brandon of Derryfield.
The Nile.
The Nile River is correct. Which song includes the lines, "Oh, beautiful for spacious skies," Tucker of Derryfield?
America the Beautiful.
America the Beautiful is right. During which war is Louisa May Alcott's Little Women set? Tucker of Derryfield.
The Civil War.
The Civil War will give your team another 10 points. Moving along very nicely, let's try one more math question here. Paper and pencil. If a dress on sale at a 33 1/3% discount is marked down to $50, what was the original price, Brandon of Derryfield?
$75.
$75 is right. You guys are going right along beautifully in round number one. Name the rigid, transparent, outermost non-living cellulose covering of most plant cells, Brandon of Derryfield.
The cell wall.
The cell wall is right. Now we want you to name the African-American who entered the race for the Democratic presidential nomination on October 10th, 1987. Tucker of Derryfield.
Jesse Jackson.
Jesse Jackson is correct. What is the most common meter used in English verse? Caitlin of Derryfield.
Prose.
Colebrook. Cormick.
Iambic pentameter.
You got it. Iambic pentameter is right. Late in round number one, here's your next 10-pointer. What law states that an older rock layer and things buried in it are underneath younger layers unless the rocks are disturbed? It's called the law of superposition. As Democrats planned their 1992 presidential election campaign, they pointed to a world leader who won a war but lost re-election for neglecting domestic concerns of jobs, national health insurance, Brandon of Derryfield.
Richard Nixon.
I'll repeat for Colebrook. As Democrats planned their 1992 presidential campaign, they pointed to a world leader who won a war but lost re-election for neglecting domestic concerns of jobs, national health insurance, and education in 1945. Name this British leader. Dean.
Winston Churchill.
You got Winston Churchill is right for the 10 points. All right, let's skip the next one for a minute, judges, and let's go to which term borrowed from architecture is used to designate the music of the era roughly from 1600 to 1750. Caitlin of Derryfield.
Baroque.
Baroque is right for your 10 points. And there's the sound ending our round. Wow, this is the highest scoring first round we've had so far this season. Well played. Derryfield on top by a score of 110. To 100. All right, we're going to take our first time out. As we do so, as you know, Laurie Warner joins us each and every week. She talks to the team members prior to the program. So let's find out what she talked to when she was meeting up with the students from Colebrook Academy.
Thanks, Jim. We're here with the students from Colebrook Academy, and their mascot is the Mohawk. Now, it's the Indian, not the hairdo, right, Teresa?
Right.
Okay. Now, Teresa, you're the captain of the team, Teresa Andolino, and you had a funny experience on your way to Granite State Challenge practice. What happened?
I was on my way to practice, and I was walking along a path, and I saw a moose, and it started chasing me.
Right? What? On foot?
Yeah.
Did you win?
Well, yeah.
Obviously, you're here. Okay. Well, that's an interesting experience. Now, any plans for college or where you're going to be going next year?
No, I'm not sure yet.
Okay. Well, you got plenty of time.
Yeah.
Okay. Next, we have Dean, the short guy on the team, Dean Woodward Neary, and you went to Boys State.
Yeah.
What did you do there?
We did a lot of stuff with government and learned a lot about state government and local government and elected a bunch of officials and things.
Now, since you're a senior, have you decided on how to perform your coup for the state government?
I kind of want to go into law when I go to college, and yeah.
That's a good way to take over. It is. Yeah. Okay, great. Thanks, Dean. And then our next student is Natalie Dosti. You're also a senior, a woman of many talents, too. You do everything from driving an 18-wheeler to National Honor Society. And the thing that you're really good at, though, is Taekwondo, which is why I'm being very nice to you. Okay, so tell us about that.
I've been doing it since about first grade. Mm-hmm. Sophomore year, I think, I got my second degree black belt, and I'm hoping to get my third next summer.
Wow. And how many degrees of black belt are there?
Nine.
Wow. That's excellent. So, and then that's a skill you can use for the rest of eternity, so
definitely.
That's cool. And our final student on this team is Cormac Frizzell. You're also a senior, so you're all seniors, so you do sports and student council and maple sugaring.
Yeah.
And how does maple sugaring work for you?
Well, pretty good. I work with my aunt and uncle there at Sugar House. It's a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. I like it a lot.
Now, do they sell it commercially?
Or yep, we sell it at my grandmother's house in Pittsburgh.
Okay, cool. All right. Well, good luck in the game. It's time for us to head back into the studio. This is Colebrook Academy. Go. Back to you, Jim.
All right, Larry. Laurie, we will go, and we thank you very much, and thanks to the students from Colebrook Academy for participating in our game this week, and they have a great game going, trailing 110 to 100 after our first round. Our second round, this is a bonus round. We'll still ask the 10-point toss-up question. Get it right, and your team has a chance at bonus points. So good luck, Colebrook and Derryfield. We know how much you love math, so let's do it one more time. What is the width of a rectangular floor 15 feet long with an area of 180 square feet? What is the width of a rectangular floor, Teresa of Colebrook? 12 feet is right for the 10 points. So we'll go over to Colebrook Academy. Teresa, you are the team captain. You can talk to everybody up here. Let's choose a category from Walk Like an Egyptian, Perimeter Problems, or Turtles and Artists. Walk Like an Egyptian, Perimeter Problems, or Turtles and Artists.
Perimeter Problems, please.
Perimeter Problems, that's what we'll give you. Teresa, again, talk to everybody. You give me the team answer, 5 points apiece. What is the perimeter of each of the following regular polygons? Hexagon with side length of 4.
24.
Correct. Octagon with a side length of 10.
80.
Correct. Decagon with a side of length 2.
20.
Simple enough. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. Let's go with another 10-point toss-up. On whose grave in Baltimore has a stranger been placing three, Dean of Colebrook Academy?
Edgar Allan Poe.
Edgar Allan Poe. 3 red roses and a bottle of cognac. Very well done. Good anticipation. Back to Colebrook we go. For Walk Like an Egyptian, Turtles and Artist, or Batter Up?
Batter up, please.
Say again.
Batter up, please.
Batter up, it'll be. Identify each of the following concerning baseball. The U.S. president who pressed a button to light the lights for the first Major League night game in 1935.
Wilson.
And take a guess.
Wilson.
It was Franklin Roosevelt. The Ohio city in which the first Major League night game was played at Crosley Field.
Cleveland.
It was Cincinnati. And the Reds pitcher who at age 15 was the youngest to play Major League Baseball.
I don't know.
Tough category. His name was Joe Nexall. Let's go with another 10-pointer. In 1994, scientists in Germany created element 110 by bombarding PB atoms with NI atoms. Name the elements represented by PB and NI, Tucker of Derryfield.
Lead and nickel.
Lead and nickel is correct. So over to the Derryfield school we'll go. Brandon, you're the team captain, so you can talk to everybody and choose between Walk Like an Egyptian, Turtles and Artist, or Ballet Bonanza.
Ballet Bonanza,
let's
please.
Go with the Ballet Bonanza. And Brandon, again, I take your answer for the team. 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following concerning ballet. The leading female dancer.
The ballerina.
Correct. Full turn on one foot.
Pirouette.
Correct. Jump in which the dancer crosses his or her legs a number of times. It's called an entrechat, but you got 10 out of 15 on the bonus. Well done, and let's try another toss-up. On September 25th, 1513, when Spanish explorer Vasco Núñez de Balboa became the first European to see the eastern shore of the Pacific Ocean, by what alliterative name did he call the ocean? Dean of Colebrook.
Peaceful.
Derryfield. He called it South Sea. On which day of the week named for the Norse god of war. Brandon of Derryfield.
Thursday.
I can repeat it for Colebrook. On which day of the week, named for the Norse god of war, does the UN open its regular sessions of the General Assembly? Dean?
Wednesday.
Let's go one more backwards. Tuesday, the third Tuesday of September specifically. All right, here we go with another 10-pointer. While studying the disease beriberi, which substances did Casimir Funk discover in 1912 and name with a combination of the word amine and the Latin word for life? Brandon of Derryfield.
Amino acid?
Good try, Colebrook Academy. You're looking specifically for vitamins. All right, we'll try one more 10-pointer. In which former Yugoslav republic did NATO peacekeeping forces collect the first weapons from Albanian rebels in 2001 in a disarmament effort? Its name begins with M. Caitlin of Derryfield.
Macedonia.
Macedonia is right for your 10 points. So back to Derryfield we go. We still are going to have you walk like an Egyptian. We have turtles and artists, and we have a science survey.
Science survey.
We're going to walk like an Egyptian right into a science survey. Here we go. Identify each of the following concerning science. Of the three main kinds of rock, the one formed when melted mineral matter cools and hardens.
Igneous.
Correct. Mass of 1 milliliter of water.
1 gram.
Correct. Ore that is the only source for the commercial production of aluminum, the most abundant metal on the Earth's crust. It is bauxite. 10 out of 15 on the bonus, and there's the sound ending our game, and we still have a dandy of a game halfway through. This thing's up for grabs. Derryfield holding on to the lead by a slim 150 to 135. All right, timeout number two before we get into our 60-second round. I'm going to call on Lori once again. This time she's talking to the team members from the Derryfield School.
Thanks so much, Jim. We're here in the studio with the students from the Derryfield School, which is located in Manchester. It's a private school, and you are the Cougars. First, we have our captain, Brandon Wilson. You're a senior from Bedford, and you're the captain of varsity crew, the downhill team. And what are your plans in the future as to what you'd like to do or how you'd incorporate sports and strategy and all sorts of good stuff like that?
Well, I'm really a competitive person, and I like to win, and I really like to help and help the team to win and practice to win.
Okay. So when you're going to school, you're planning on staying in teams and perhaps skiing? And
yeah, I'm planning on rowing in college.
Oh, cool. All right, that's a great thing. It is. All right, next we have Caitlin Fink. You're also from Bedford. You're a junior. And the random fact about you was that in elementary school, you wrote an opera.
Yeah, we had an artist-in-residence program, and we had worked to develop a learning park in front of our school, and we wrote an opera and performed in it about the creation of our learning park, and I was the turtle, so.
So you got to help write your part?
Yes.
That's excellent, okay. And next is Kate Jorgensen. You are a junior and from Bedford also. Now, you like math, archery, singing, and calligraphy. How did you end up learning how to do calligraphy?
Well, I really like to read, and part of reading is definitely words, and focusing on words and emphasizing their beauty is really a big thing about writing, so. Mm-hmm. I really got into writing them beautifully.
That's nice. Wait, is there a teacher or did you teach yourself?
I taught myself to do it.
That's really cool. And our last student to talk to is Tucker DiNapoli. You are from Manchester and a senior. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy is what caught me about you. So I was wondering if, like, when you graduate, that's what you're planning on doing.
Not really. I want to go to New York City and go to college there. So, you know, that's a big thing for me. But I've read that book, you know, a dozen times. And it's just a really, you know, good book and sort of good guide to life.
It is. It's definitely random, that's for sure. Yeah. Okay, so we had to head back into the studio. We will continue the game. It's over to you, Jim.
Again, thank you, Lori, and to the team members from the Derryfield School who are holding on to a 15-point lead halfway through the game. This is round number three. This will be our 60-second round. We'll ask each team 10 questions in 1 minute. We'll reward them with 10 points for every correct answer and bonus them 10 points should they get them all correct in under a minute. So the team trailing gets to choose the categories first. So let's go over to Colebrook, and you can choose from All About Walls, Ring Out the Old, Ring In the New, or Surrounded by Science. All About Walls, Ring Out the Old, Ring In the New, or Surrounded by Science.
The ring
Well, you want to go the ring out the old and ring in the new. All right. And Teresa, you're the team captain. As you have been whole game, we take your answer for the team after you talk to them. Identify each of the following associated with the words old or new. Start the clock. Agricultural implement carried by the figure used to portray the old or outgoing year at New Year's.
Father Time.
It was a scythe. Old blank, the nickname of the U.S. flag.
Old Glory.
Correct. European city whose old name was Constantinople.
Istanbul.
Correct. Dictionary word beginning with O, used to label an old-fashioned word no longer in common use.
Obsolete.
Correct. Jewish holy book consisting of the first five Old Testament books.
Torah.
Correct. Completion of the saying, you can't teach an old blank new tricks.
Dog.
Correct. Possessive in the idiom, old blank's tale, for a superstition passed by word of mouth.
Wives.
Correct. Donald Rumsfeld's replacement, who in confirmation hearings pledged to consider new options in Iraq.
Robert Gates.
Correct. Greek prefix for new as used in the word blank classic, used to designate a new version or revival of the style of ancient Greece or Rome in architecture or the arts. Sorry about that, judges. Well done, though. 7 out of their 10 on their 60-second round. So we're going to put 70 points onto the scoreboard for them and turn over to Derryfield. We have All About Walls, and we have Surrounded by Science. Go ahead.
We'll take science, please.
Let's go with the science. And Brandon, you talk to everybody. I take your answer for the team. Identify each of the following concerning science. Start the clock. Polish astronomer who revolutionized the concept.
Kepler.
It is Copernicus. Two main elements in table salt.
Sodium and chloride.
Sodium and chlorine. Planet and element named for a god known for his speed.
Mercury.
Correct. Mass of a paperclip in the SI system.
1 gram.
Correct. Term meaning having a balance of two.
Pass.
Group of chemical elements made up of salt producers.
Pass.
Word ending in sphere that designates the layer of the atmosphere closest to the Earth.
Troposphere.
Correct. Movable bone at the front of the knee.
Patella.
Correct. American called the first black man of science and the African astronomer.
Pass.
More common name for the world's tallest living tree.
Californian redwood.
Yeah, we'll take that for a correct answer, judges. They got 5 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So look at this, as we have gone through 3 rounds. We keep going back and forth, and we have a dandy of a game going with 1 round left as Colebrook holds onto a lead, 205 to 200. 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way, teams. No more talking to each other. Good luck. Here we go, on to the second round. Perhaps the most valuable photograph ever made, a mural-sized print of this Ansel Adams work, sold for $71,500 in 1981. The photograph shows the moon climbing into a black sky, illuminating clouds, a chain of mountain peaks, an adobe church, and a small houses near a graveyard. What is the title? It is called Moonrise. In which of Jonathan Swift's fictional countries would today's micro machines, one smaller than a pinhead, be most appropriate? Dean of Colebrook.
Micronesia.
Could try Derryfield School. The fictional country would be Lilliput from Gulliver's Travels. All right, we have about 2 minutes to go in the game. We got one more math type of question, although more science. Find the centripetal force needed to keep a 3-kilogram object moving in a circle of radius 1 meter at a speed of 2 meters per second. Brandon of Derryfield.
6 newtons.
Colebrook. It is 12 newtons. Which large rounded temple did Emperor Hadrian design and have constructed in Rome and is dedicated to all the gods? Dean of Colebrook.
Colosseum.
Derryfield. Brandon.
The Pantheon.
Pantheon is right. A German drug company once marketed this now illegal narcotic, naming it for the way it made test subjects feel heroic. What is it? Tucker of Derryfield.
Heroin.
Heroin is right. Which architectural term for the top projection of a cornice or the circular chandelier hanging from the ceiling of a church also names the crown-like part of a flower? Tucker of Derryfield. Colebrook. It is the corona, just under a minute to play. Name the planet whose rings scientists now attribute to Brandon of Derryfield.
Saturn.
I can repeat it for Colebrook. Name the planet whose rings scientists now attribute to moon dust, kicked up as asteroids and comets struck its four small moons rather than its larger, more distant moon, Io. It's often called the giant planet. Natalie.
Jupiter.
Jupiter is right. Which symbol of the Cold War was opened after 28 years of November Tucker of Derryfield?
The Berlin Wall.
The Berlin Wall is right. The New York, try this one. What is the script of an opera called? Caitlin of Derryfield.
A libretto.
A libretto is right. As of August 1st, 2001, Azerbaijan adopted the Roman alphabet to replace. Where's the sound ending our game? And look at this, a wonderful, wonderful first round game. Derryfield School holding on to the win by a final of 240 to 215. I think this is probably one of the highest scoring first rounds we've had so far. So we congratulate both teams, Derryfield for moving on and Colebrook Academy for a tremendous performance tonight. Well, if you like this one, hopefully we'll do it all over again in 1 week as the teams from Guilford High School and Hanover High School go head to head. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. See you next week. Good night, everybody.